Hi, this is Peter Stanley. Welcome to my channel. I want to give an update on my indoor grow so far this year. A lot of it's going to be an outdoor grow at some point, but today's March 4th, 2017. This is a Chiltepin yellow in a Kratky container. It's actually starting to look a lot better than it used to. And behind it is my Jamaican hot chocolate. And it is kind of, the canopy starting to eclipse the Thai dragon that I've got here. And the Tien Sin, which is it's a Chinese red pepper. It's often used in cooking. Both the Tien Sin and the Thai dragon are both in self-watering containers. They're doing well. I'm going to prune this guy back and then take some little off the top, but it's been growing like crazy. This is going to go into a large Kratky setup outside when it's probably in early May. This is my high pressure aeroponic system that I made, the new version. It's doing better. I changed out the nutrients for a stronger formula, and I turned off the timer, so it's not cycling 5 minute intervals. The pump's just running continuously, and the fan's running continuously. The UFO light here, and since I did that, the growth is kind of taken off. I've got a lot of video I need to edit, but I wanted to see how this was doing. But I'll put a video up soon on how I made this. Okay, these are ones I've potted up. I've got upstairs under the T8 lights. And I'm not going to go through all these. They're kind of hard to pull out. I need to, still need to rearrange, and I'm going to add a couple more shop lights here. And, but all these are double cupped. With these 20 ounce cups, you have that much of an offset. But still, it's kind of a pain to fill these. So I'm working on a wick, like a micro wick system. Yeah. So with this, again, I made a little fill pipe, and looking back, I don't think it's worth the trouble. You can just kind of lift and fill. But it's you can see I've got a microfiber wick. And solution down in there. It's kind of hard to see. Oops. Fix that. Anyway, there's a 3-inch net pot in the bottom, and that's holding the plant and the little bit of potting mix. And so let me clean this mess up. I just dropped my Puerto Rican yellow all over the electrical thing there. I need to fix that. I need to redo all of this and prevent things like that from happening. I just recently got this upstairs, and this really needs to be in a container like this. But anyway, so yeah, that's the how I'm doing this. I'm gonna try to do all my future transplants using this method, and try to redo some of my older ones that way too. I think it'll be easier without having to fill as often, and it'll should get a good continuous feed as it grows. I need to get more stuff growing in here, but I've got some cinnamon, basil, and sage. And this is a sage cutting I took from some I bought at the grocery store. So I want to see if it'll produce roots. It's one of my air gardens. And most of these are ready to go into cups. So I'll put some smaller things in there once I transfer these out. And this is going to be a Kratky herb garden that I'm going to set up. I'll kind of probably do that today if I have time. This is my Blue Christmas. It's in the Kratky container. It started from seed. And got some various. There's a white devil's tail in Kratky. One of my early videos I was showing about transferring sprouts and seed starting, and this was the little example I did I think it's broccoli, but I'm not sure. And this is the TNCN that I did in that video. And the one that's in the container I just showed is one of these, one of the sprouts that came out of here. Got some rosemary back in there. This is a lemon balm. More sage. These are clones of the ahi pineapple. I'm going to show in a second. And they all have roots. See back there. I need to bump up the nutrient strength. See, these are a little yellow. It's a little deficient. So they're still using the weaker solution that I use. So I'll probably change that out this weekend. Something stronger. Some things I've got in the air garden sprout. I switched out with the seed starter deck. So I've got some cinnamon basil, Italian basil in the middle. There's some peppers. Can't really see, but I got some really neat peppers back there. Queen Laurie, Swiss chocolate, Benny Highlands, dwarf Mexican pequin, and a Geronimo. There's also an ahi jabito that hasn't sprouted yet. This is my, it's a cross by a D3 from the hot pepper. It's called ahi pineapple, and it's an F2. But it's a cross between ahi pineapple and a butch tea yellow scorpion. And this thing has just been an absolute beast. It's like 61 days from the time I planted the seed, and it's already got a bunch of little buds forming. And I've taken a lot of four clones off. One of the clones a friend of mine has, but it's gotten so big I've actually had to add this little support that comes with the bounty. And I'm probably going to take one or two more clone cuttings. I might do a video on how I'm doing this to show. It's real easy. You don't need to use any rooting hormone or anything. So this thing is just crazy. So that's my update for March 4th. Thank you for watching, and please like, comment, and subscribe.